Understanding the Full Costs of Research at UHN. What is biomedical research? Biomedical research is research with the goal of understanding human health and disease at the molecular, cellular, organ system, and whole body levels. It includes the development of tools and techniques to be applied for this purpose, and developing new therapies or devices that improve health or the quality of life of individuals. In Canada, most of the nation's biomedical research happens in research hospitals, which are partnered with major universities. Research hospitals provide care for the rarest and most complex conditions, teach future healthcare providers, and move research results into practice. Over the past decade, biomedical research spending in Canada has grown by 33%, with the top 40 research hospitals spending $2.9 billion annually. Despite this steep growth, the funding model is not sustainable. The University Health Network, or UHN, is Canada's largest research academic hospital. Research activity here spans basic discovery, translational research, and clinical trials across numerous diseases and disciplines, including cancer, cardiology, transplantation, immunology, infectious disease, rehabilitation, neural and visual sciences, musculoskeletal disease, and community and population health. UHN spends approximately $500 million annually on biomedical research. But where does this funding come from? Over 1,000 researchers at UHN apply for funding from various external sponsors every year to support their research activities. 40% of funds are raised through philanthropy by hospital-based foundations. 15% are awarded by health charities. 20% are from federal and provincial governments. Another 20% comes from partnerships with industry. And 5% of funds are from UHN and non-government sources. So what is this funding for? There are two types of costs associated with research. The first is the direct cost of research. Funds are awarded to cover the direct cost of a project and are spent under the direction of a scientist. These pay for costs such as research trainees, graduate students and postdoctoral fellows, technicians and other research personnel, as well as supplies and equipment, travel, publication costs, and other costs associated with conducting and sharing the research. However, to conduct this research, scientists need other types of support, and this is where another type of cost of research comes in. These are organizational costs, or indirect costs. Organizational costs are incurred and managed by the institution to support the conduct of research. They include paying for scientists' salaries, paying for the rent, maintenance of research buildings, and utilities such as electricity, water, HVAC, and security, as well as support services like IT, finance, grants, human resources, legal, and staff that ensure compliance with government regulations and health and safety regulations that protect our researchers, staff, students, and patients. These organizational costs are an essential part of the price of doing research. Out of that $500 million spent on research in 2020, 60% was associated with direct costs and 40% with organizational costs. And these are proportions that are comparable to research hospitals across Canada. So, the research grant funding covers all of these costs, right? They do not. In 2020, organizational costs incurred to support research at UHN amounted to approximately $195 million. Contributions from our foundations, research grants, and awards covered $155 million of these expenses. This left a shortfall of $40 million, or over 20% of organizational costs, that UHN had to find. Why is this? UHN and other research institutions can recover a limited amount of funding for these costs from research grants, and only if the sponsors allow for them. For UHN to continue to sustain its research activities and to even plan for future growth and research, it's critical that the full costs, both direct and organizational, are accounted for to the maximum extent allowable for each research project. The inability to cover the full costs of research, including organizational costs, hurts UHN's researchers, staff, and trainees, and significantly impedes our ability to support the advancement of important biomedical discoveries. It would also prevent us from being able to maintain large, specialized equipment and facilities that are shared among researchers, and provide administrators who ensure the operations, safety, and compliance of research activities. It would also hurt our ability to plan for and construct new buildings and cutting-edge facilities needed for the latest research. The bottom line is that the full costs of research must be accounted for and covered to ensure that we grow research through financially sustainable structures and fulfill our mission together to drive excellence in discovery and innovation to create a healthier world.